today's episode, we're going to chat about our biggest rival, fear. And I'm going to show you exactly how you can completely remove fear forever in less than 30 minutes. I'm Ma, and I'm a boudoir photographer and business and marketing mentor helping creatives turn their passion into profits. On this channel, I share tips, tricks, and hacks helping you have a wildly successful and profitable photography business. We all know what fear feels like. It can be very traumatizing and paralyze us from moving forward to the things that we truly want. Remember how fear of the unknown monster under our bed would basically paralyze us and keep us in bed at night? I'm pretty sure our parents probably used that fear against us. But hit the like button below if you have ever felt fear. So if the views on this video don't match the likes, then I'm going to know that some of you guys, A, aren't actually human, saying you haven't felt fear, B, are purposely not clicking the like button because you hate being told what to do, or C, you're just being lazy. My point being is we have all known and experienced fear or a version of fear in our life. Fear is actually not necessarily a bad thing. It is instinctually there to actually protect us. It's meant to keep us from harm and to help us survive. So where it becomes a problem is when it is keeping us from, like keeping us stuck and preventing us from doing something that we actually want to do or experience. It's where we perceive there to be a threat to us, but there isn't an actual threat. The fear I personally have most recently had to overcome in order to do something that I really wanted to do is overcome speaking on video. I was seriously petrified 6 months ago to be on video, like sweating armpits, my voice would shake. I literally probably would rather smash my thumb with a hammer than be on video. It's pretty silly, right? No one said fear was rational. There are times when fear is healthy and it actually protects us, but then there are times that getting over that fear is going to allow us to move onwards towards a healthier, happier version of ourselves and towards the life that we truly want to live. I think one of the biggest fears I feel like that we as humans have that doesn't really serve us to live up to our potential is the fear of what others think of us or will think of us if we do X. So fill in the blank. So how do we deal with fear and get past it so that it's not holding us back from what we truly want and our true potential? There's actually a really simple formula or exercise called fear setting, which I found out about through Timothy Ferris. It's like the reverse of goal setting, but in my opinion, it is so much more powerful. It's easy to set goals and work towards something that we want, but to face our fears, that can be a lot harder and a lot more uncomfortable. But it doesn't have to be that way anymore. So here's how you go about fear setting. So go grab a piece of paper and a pen if you want to do this exercise and follow along, or you can do it later, that's fine too. But step one is to write down something you have fear around doing. For the sake of this video, I'm going to use one of my coaching clients as an example, as I did this exact technique with her to overcome her fear of quitting her job and going full-time in her boudoir photography business. So write down something that you have fear around taking action. She was literally working at her corporate job and spending every waking hour outside of her job doing her photography business, working every weekend and basically 7 days a week, never getting a break. She knew something needed to change, and she knew her goal was to make all of her income from her photography. It's actually been her goal for 10 years to quit her job and do her photography full time, but her fear was holding her back and paralyzing her from taking that next step to actually have the life that she wants. So for her, that was the action she had fear around. So her step one is, what if I quit my steady part-time job to go full-time with my boudoir business? So step two is, write down 1 to 3 worst-case scenarios of taking that action that you have fear around. For my client, it was the fact that she was the breadwinner currently, as her husband was in school full time. So it was, what if I can't make as much money consistently as I am with my job? That was one of her fears. I like worst case scenarios, if you will, if money didn't come in as consistently as when she had a job. These are like your what if thoughts. What if I invest money into my photography business, but I don't get it back immediately? What if my significant other doesn't understand my desire to create a business from my passion? What if people think I'm blank? You know, what if people think I'm not good enough? What if people don't think that I can run a business? What if people don't think that my photography artwork is good enough to pay for? There's all of these thoughts, and they're valid thoughts because they're trying to protect us physically and emotionally in some way. But by acknowledging them, being aware of them, and writing them down, this is what's going to give us the power to overcome them through this exercise. So write down 1 to 3 worst case scenarios that might happen if you took the action that you wrote down in step one. All right, step three is to write down 1 to 3 things that you can proactively do to prevent those what ifs or those fears or worst case scenarios in step two from happening. So 1 to 3 things for each fear or worst case scenario that you wrote down in step two. So for example, I can't quite remember exactly what we came up with for my client, but her fear, worst case scenario of quitting her job, like I said, was basically she's currently the breadwinner because her husband's in school full time. And what if she can't make enough money consistently if she doesn't have that part-time job? So in this step, we're going to say, how can she prevent that from happening? So couple of things that she could do is she could pre-plan how much additional income that she needs to make from her business to equal what she's making at her job right now. Then write down how many shoots per month that she would need to average to get to that number. Another thing that she could do is she could perhaps raise or restructure her pricing to increase her profits per shoot. So that with however many that shoots that she's booking now, she'll be making more money if she can consistently keep that many number of shoots going. Another thing is she could make sure that she has a solid marketing system that is getting her steady inquiries from ideal clients to ensure that she has consistency in her business and her income. She could and should chat with her significant other and make sure that they're on the same page. She could make sure that she has a good support system before taking that leap in case she needs encouragement or support or help or has questions along the way. So that's what she has me for. She could look at their current family budget and see where they could cut back and tighten up in order to make her dream of being her own boss and doing what she loves full time a reality. These are all things that she can do to prevent that worst case scenario from happening. So write down 1 to 3, that was more than 3, I think, ideas. If you have more ideas, that's okay. So write down the things that you could do to prevent the worst case scenarios from happening. Step 4 is write down 1 to 3 things that you could do to rectify the situation if that worst case scenario happened. So do that for each fear or worst case scenario that you wrote down in step 2. For my client, if she quit her job and wasn't able to make enough money, what could she do? She could go back and get her old job back. When I asked her if this was a possibility, she said it was totally possible, and you could just see the relief and the fear disappear off of her face when she realized that that was even a possibility. So you can see how walking through this fear setting exercise really helps us see our fears and what we can do to disappear them. My hubby always quotes someone that says that all FEAR stands for is false evidence appearing real. So going through this exercise helps us see that false evidence, helps us come up with steps for preventing it from happening, and gives us a game plan for if it ever actually was to happen, and gives us back control over our decisions and life and stops letting fear control us. Now that we can see everything laid out on paper and have a plan, it's not so scary anymore and the fear disappears. So the final step to really getting us over that hesitation of moving forward and doing something that we actually want to do is to do what is called future pacing. I can't remember if this is exactly what Timothy Ferris calls it, this step, but his concept is similar. In this step, I want you to write down what your life is going to look like and be like when you finally take this action and get where you're wanting to go. So how are you going to feel? How will your life look different? What will change for you and your family? What is now possible? So for my client, she no longer has to lose hours of her life commuting to work every day. She's going to get that time back for herself, her family, and actually be able to spend time with her friends that she hasn't had time to do currently. So the other thing was, she no longer has to sit in her corporate office anymore, staring out the window or at the wall, dreaming about being in her studio, doing what she really wants to be doing. She's going to be able to set her own schedule and not have limited vacation days. Travel was something that was really, really important to her. She is going to live her dream doing what she loves most. That's what we all want, right? she's going to feel free and empowered and happy. And she's going to be able to impact more women's lives through her boudoir photography and show them their true beauty, helping them learn self-love, which is one of her biggest passions. I totally get it since I'm a boudoir photographer myself. You probably get the point, but this step is so crucial, so don't skip it. Future pacing just means to imagine exactly how you're going to feel, what it's gonna be like, what is life gonna look like, what's it gonna taste like, depending on what it is that you're trying to disappear the fear around. What is gonna happen when you reach that milestone? It's visualizing and tricking the mind into believing that it's already happened. I don't know if you guys know this, but our brains actually don't know the difference. So that's probably a whole nother video on the power of visualization, but it's incredible what our brains can do. You guys can use fear setting for anything. It doesn't have to be some big decision. It can be a small fear or a big fear. Like for example, we thought about maybe giving up our home base and traveling full time last year. And I had a little bit of fear around not having a place to go home to and be grounded in. And so we did this fear setting exercise around it. We actually disappeared all of the fear, but we didn't end up actually moving forward with that decision. It just ended up not being the right decision for us at that time. But I didn't have any fear around it after doing the fear setting exercise. Another, it could be as small even as whether to put your kid into soccer. Like maybe it's something that your kid wants to do, but you kind of were like, man, I'm not really sure that this is a good idea. And you have some sort of fear or some sort of things, resistance that is holding you back from making that decision. So anything that you have resistance or fear around, literally use this exercise and write it all out, and it will literally help you get clarity on what decision is the right thing for you, and also just disappear that resistance and disappear that fear. So to summarize, anytime you feel fear around taking an action, whether it's big or small, use this fear setting exercise. And step one is write down the feared action. If I do this, I fear X. Step two is write down the top 1 to 3 fears or worst case scenarios if you take that action in step one. Step three would be write down 1 to 3 preventative actions that you can take for each scenario you listed in step two. Step four is going to be writing down 1 to 3 corrective actions you can take for each listed feared scenario or worst case scenario if it should happen. And step five is to future pace and visualize what your life is going to be like, how you're going to feel, and what is going to be different once you achieve that goal you're wanting to reach. And write it all down. This is important to write it down. And finally, step six is go take action now that you've disappeared that fear. Comment below and let me know what fear that you're going to disappear with this fear setting exercise, and let me know afterwards how you feel after doing the exercise. It is so crazy how effective it is. I can't wait to hear you guys' results. If you thought this video was helpful, give it a thumbs up and share it with someone that you love. Everyone needs to have this amazing tool to use to break through their fear and to really live a life that they love and live up to their full potential. As always, make sure to subscribe if you haven't yet. I will see you guys in the next video.